I'm Jon Phillips, and I'm very, very particular about what I put on my wrist.
Okay, Jon, wearables right or wrong? The Martian notifier is the future of smartwatch design.
This is wrong.
Wrong!
There are a lot of things I really do like about the Martian watch. I love the fact that it looks like a traditional wristwatch, and it keeps things simple without a lot of features. Basically, it just gives you notifications. So it could show you notifications for email, text, incoming phone calls. It can even show you the weather, which is really cool. However, I really can't call it the future of smartwatch design. It only costs $129 and it looks like a $129 watch. It really doesn't have the fit and finish of a luxury watch. The other thing is that Android Wear watches are coming out later this summer, and these could be the future of what we want to see in smartwatches.
Next question, wearables right or wrong? Wearables companies are ignoring the women's market at their peril.
This is right.
That's right.
So this week we saw the release of Ringly, an extremely feminine smart ring that sends notifications to your finger, and it's definitely a step in the right direction. But it's actually only the third wearable we've seen this year that directly addresses the women's market. The first was Cuff, a line of smart jewelry, and of course Google just announced the new glass frames designed by Dion von Furstenberg. Now you would think the wearables industry would take the women's market much more seriously. Let's think about this. Women use smartphones. Women accessorize more than men, and women make up more than half the world's population. Yet for some reason, this group of manufacturers is not catering to this market. It's absolute madness.
Wearables right or wrong? It makes perfect sense to ban Google Glass from movie theaters.
This is wrong.
Wrong!
So Alamo Drafthouse is making headlines because they are now banning Google Glass from their small chain of theaters. The theater owner has a long history of banning texting because texting is annoying, but now he's banning Glass because he says it's a piracy risk. First of all, when you're recording video with Glass, the battery lasts just about 1 hour during continuous use, and that's not long enough to record an entire movie. Second of all, who would be the most obvious pirater in the theater but the guy wearing Google Glass? You have to be kidding me. If I'm gonna pirate a movie with modern technology, I'm gonna take a GoPro camera, stick it underneath my trucker's hat, and call it a day. The video quality will be better, and I won't have a bunch of people yelling on my video, "Hey, look at that doofus wearing Google Glass."